Fire is the most devastating thing that can happen to anyone, anytime, anywhere. Just have a look at how close the fire came to this property not so long ago. When the flames are that close, your firefighting kit needs to be ready to go. So let's have a look at some basic service and maintenance. So the pump we'll be looking at in this video is the Crommelins Twin Impeller Fire Pump. So the things we're going to cover off today are engine maintenance, pump maintenance, and we're also going to have a look at our hose and fittings. There's a few things we're going to look at is oil. Oil stick over here. We're just going to take that out. Well, that's nice clean oil. And the level looks pretty good as well. So I'm happy with that. The air cleaner. Secondary nut. Now that's really nice and clean, so we don't have to worry too much about that. So we've got good oil, good air cleaner. Last of all, fresh fuel to go in as well. So pump maintenance involves checking your suction port for air leaks, your non-return valve is functioning properly, your O-rings on your discharge caps are working correctly, also on your flooding cap and on your discharge drain plug as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to open this pump up and have a good look. To pull the pump apart, it's quite simple. Undo these bolts on the outside, these ones here, these four here, lay it out. Let's have a look. A handy tip before you start pulling your pump apart, drop in and see your local service agent and get yourself a service kit organised in advance. So you can see here our non-return valve hasn't been working properly because of all this muck built up at the back here, not allowing it to sit flush with the face. Okay, so I've now taken all the bolts off the pump, suction port, discharge port, and let's have a look inside. Oh wow, okay, so you can see we've had a fair bit of calcium build up in here. We've had water sitting. You can see this build up of dirt. So first of all, we're going to give that a bit of a clean out. All this oxidization, we're going to give that a bit of a wash off. All this excess sand. Let's just give the outside a bit of a clean up first. As this is a twin impeller pump, I've also removed the front diffuser case so we can access the back O-ring. So the pump's all apart, nice and clean. Let's remove some of these old O-rings. Take the outer side one off, the one around the diffuser. Now, as I said, on the single impeller pumps, you won't have this O-ring on the inside. Okay, that one's off. So put the O-ring in for the diffuser. Now I'm just gonna put the diffuser back over the top. Nice seal. We'll now put the large bottle O-ring on. Just cleaning that off is going to make the O-rings sit better and give us a better seal. Have a look at our suction port. As you can see, it's a little bit rusty, so we'll give that a bit of a clean up as well. Now I want to put my new non-return valve onto my suction port. That weight's actually quite serviceable again, so we can actually recycle that one rather than replacing it, but we'll definitely put a new gasket in. Okay, so the weight has now been added to the gasket. So now we've used our recycled weight for our non-return valve, and it's quite simple. That will fit onto the back like so. When it's up, closes, doesn't let any back water out. So now I'm just fitting new O-rings to my flooding cap and also to my drain plug. Now I'm just going to reassemble the rest of the pump. Okay, so what we're looking for in our hoses, this is our discharge. We need to make sure that the connection's in good working order and that the washer is actually still inside, that the hose clamp is done up nice and tight. Likewise on the spray nozzle, our clamp is done up tight. And on our suction hose, this one is the most important. Air coming into this one's going to cause you problems with priming. Make sure again that the fitting is in good working order, gasket's fitted, hose clamp is nice and tight. Look for any fractures, cracks, splits or anything in the hose itself. And then we're ready to give it a go. Let's prime the pump. Remove the flooding cap on the top. This is why we need that non-return valve, because that'll keep the water actually in the pump to keep the prime next time. So there you are. That's how simple it is to service and maintain your firefighting kit, your pump, your hose and accessories, and make sure you're ready for any emergency that may come your way. Thanks and bye for now.